nanoHUB-U, online instruction.
Hey everyone, welcome back. So this is lecture 122, and this is going to be a summary of the overall unit one, kind of looking back at what did we learn from all of the information that I presented. So the first really big take-home message of this unit is that we can formulate an eigenproblem from Maxwell's equations, and that that eigenproblem can be solved using the Bloch theorem. So why is that so important? First of all, like that will allow us to predict the relationship between frequency and wave vector, and then it'll also tell us a lot about if we have any kind of unusual or non-trivial behavior, such as photonic band gaps in the system. And then that, of course, can lead to lots of different applications down the road, which I'll talk in a little more detail about later. But for now, we can just basically, first of all, write down the Maxwell eigenproblem, which again is just a combination of Faraday's law and then Ampere's law with Maxwell's correction and enforcing the transversality of H because there are no magnetic monopoles. And then we can use the Bloch solution, which is just a combination of a periodic function for H, which can be also written as a Fourier series times a plane wave. And then that allows us to turn what otherwise looks like a very unwieldy analytical problem into a matrix algebra type problem. And then you can see that actually the matrix formulation kind of looks like this. And then we can actually solve that using a tool that's already in existence called MIT Photonic Bands. And you can access it at this website, jdjmit.edu/mpb. And then once we have that capability, then we can start to calculate all kinds of things when we have periodic dielectric media. So if we start with 2D structures, which we could say are kind of the first real innovations in photonic crystals, given that 1D periodic structures have been known for more than a century, then we find that we get actually potentially photonic band gaps both in transverse electric and transverse magnetic polarizations, which basically correspond to E field or H field being in the plane of the 2D photonic crystal structure. And in particular, if we have a triangular lattice of holes that are punched into high index medium, we find that in this special region of radii, we can actually get fairly significant band gaps, and we can actually tune the band gap based on the radius as well, both for TE and TM at the same time. And then second, we actually find that we can have 1D periodic structures that are etched into index-guided structures. And then this gives rise to a set of band gaps that are below what we call the light line. And then when we're below the light line in this yellow region, then we can actually also add defects on top of that. And then these defects create like strongly localized modes, and they're partially localized because of the photonic band gap or periodicity in one direction, but also partially localized by the index guiding effect, which creates confinement at one or more band gap frequencies, which are kind of in somewhere in the yellow region, and they can be tuned based on the nature of the defect that you introduce. And then we also found something very similar holds if we have a 2D structure that has a finite thickness with periodicity in the X and Y directions, which we call a photonic crystal slab. And then in the photonic crystal slab, again, we have a band gap, which is depicted in this case in blue. And then we can also, again, create defects. In this case, I've created a whole array of defects in a line. And so this creates kind of a waveguide. And then this waveguide actually can be index guided out of the board. And you can see that here in the far right illustration, that it exponentially decays up and down in the z direction. And at the same time, it can flow smoothly in the lateral directions. And you can even like adjust the direction of the defects to go wherever you need it to go. And then also we found that we can create 3D photonic crystals out of composites of different 2D structures that are stacked layer by layer into 3D capability. And they have actually true 3D photonic band gaps in all possible directions and polarizations. And then we also found that we can have confinement not just in the lateral direction, but also in the vertical direction, even if we remove the high index materials. So we can actually get away from relying on refractive index waveguiding in this 3D structure and have a true 3D confinement with very high quality factor and very low volume. And then in terms of the solvers that we talked about, the key methodology was using MPB, which essentially reformulates the essential eigenproblem, which we mentioned at the beginning, in a very efficient way, and essentially rewrites the H field as a discrete Fourier transform problem. And then that can be solved using a combination of fast Fourier transforms and then inverse fast Fourier transforms, and is augmented by tensor-based averaging, and essentially afterwards performs a conjugate gradient minimization of a Bloch-Rayleigh quotient, which is related to Rayleigh-Ritz minimization, which is very common variational method in quantum mechanics. So in short, we showed that it's easy to calculate band structures, and we can learn a lot from them.